Good morning, everybody. We are still have got few minutes to go. I have already seen some attendees are already here. Thank you so much for joining us today on this Saturday. And we normally meet at 11 a.m. on the Saturdays, what we decide to come up with a subject on a webinar. So this is one of those webinars where we will talk about how to convert your leads into the sales and how to generate more leads, because more leads means more sales. Project, good morning. You want to speak? You want to share something? Project Tiware, you want to say something? Mr. Riyaz, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
How are you?
I'm good.
Thanks for joining today. Let us see what happens today.
We will
take a lot of your time, but we'll definitely use this 1 hour, 15 minutes on a very efficient way. Promise.
Thanks.
Bharti, good morning. Bharti, you can unmute and wish everybody good morning. I think they are not able to hear me, probably.
Good morning, all.
Good morning. Hardik, good morning. Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, can hear you.
Okay. That's great. Let's wait for another 5 minutes. There are still people joining here. What is the great news today in the social media? Can you tell me? Anybody can come up and, you know, just speak. What is the great news today in the social media? Hello. Everybody is silent. Let's do one thing. Can you just keep on chatting in the chat box? Please let us know about all of you. Let's keep the chat box buzzing for some time. I would request some of you to just, you know, put their names and what they are doing, what is their current business or what is their profession in the chat box. Can somebody start doing that? Okay. Thank you. Anybody else? There is, don't put it only to the panelists. Please use all panelists and attendees. Please use all panelists and attendees so that, you know, everybody can see what is what are your profession and what you are actually doing and what is your name. It will become easy. Good morning, Sandeep ji. Thank you for joining us. That's good news. I think lockdown will be there till 15th May only. Sometimes lockdown becomes a blessing rather than a curse. And some people are really making more profit than they have been doing before the lockdown. That's great. Riyaz, professional sales and marketing. That's great. So 2 minutes to go more. I think sometimes I feel, you know, people who are joining on time are really punished because of the people who doesn't want to join on time. Do you agree with me? Sometimes I feel that when we are in time and we get penalized because we are on time, because some people does not want to come on time. This is really sad, but it happens in this way. We can't help it. Okay. Yes, agree. Time is money, money is time. Correct. So let me introduce myself. My name is Kaushik Chandra and I am a business coach. Within a minute, I will share my screen because ultimately today I am here to discuss about how to get the lead successfully into, how to shift the lead successfully into sales. And whatever today we will discuss out here, it is all a part of the experiences which I had in my career, as well as a part of the lessons which I have derived from where I took my lessons through. So let me get into the presentation and let me start from there itself. It will help us to, you know, can you see all of you the slides? If you can just put some, you know, chat there, yes or no. If you can all see, then it is perfect. If you're not able to see, please raise your hands. We will find out why we are not able to see that. Okay. So today we are going to discuss about driving leads to success. Leads is something we don't give a proper value to it, but we need to give value to it. So I thought, you know, let me sit upon to find out what is the points which we need to understand and which we need to honor actually to see that they lead to the success. Okay. So this is something a little bit about me. I'm an entrepreneur and a business strategist. And I help people in developing their business to find out a way to more profitability. I am also a mentor. And with 30 plus of years experiences in sales and marketing coupled up with you know, team building, vision planning, and of course, if you are not setting your goals, you cannot be at the helm of the organization. So there are different industries I've worked for, starting from Jail Morrison to JBM, JNT, to Putney Computer Systems of Mumbai, and then Epson, KEI. And I was fortunate actually to network with around 1,000 plus entrepreneurs across the country. Needless to say, I have been traveling during my career around 11 cities in this country, and I stayed there and I have met business people, worked with them at their own places. So that is one of the pride which I always carry with me. And yet it has given me immense experiences and friendship along my career. With those type of experiences, what I gained around my career, I thought that, okay, let me start a very, give a twist to my entire career and become a business coach. So I am a certified, ISF certified. ISF certified is nothing to do with business coaching, but I take a pride of it because this is for color calibration. So whatever the colors you see in your TVs or different panels, they are actually calibrated by some certified people. And I am one of those ISF certified people in this country. After that, I have done my certification as a business coach from Action Coach Las Vegas. Action Coach has got 380 plus tested growth strategies with them, by which we help our entrepreneurs to get into the profitability of their businesses. We have around satisfied 450 clients across the country. I am also a certified life coach and associated with SME Chamber of India. So while working with SME Chamber of India, I learned a lot of things. And definitely, I would share some of them in this particular webinar. SME Chamber of India, the SMEs and the MSMEs of this country, is for the people who doesn't understand or who are still struggling with the word SME or MSME, I just want to make it clear to them. SME is small medium enterprises and MSME is micro small medium enterprises. So there are a lot of benefits when you become a member of MSMEs. I will keep that for a different forum on this. What are the benefits when you become a member of an MSME, when you have got an Udyan certificate for you? It is really, really very, very efficient tool to run this business, to that extent that even if your customer is not paying money within a particular time, and if you're an Udyan certified MSME member, they take steps to get your money through. Okay, but the action is only taken after 45 days through proper paperwork channels. It is not that it doesn't happen, it has happened, and they are happening, and people are making it happening. So we will take this chapter later sometime in some other, forum. Going forward, Action Coach is solely owned by Mr. Brad Sugars, and I like his word. Where you will be in the next 5 years will depend upon the books you read. I repeat, where you will be in the next 5 years will depend upon the books you read and the people you associate with. Thus, the actions you take. So it's a combination of learning, collaboration, and actions. It's a very interesting, somebody, if you're interested to take it down, please take it down. There are a few dialogues, there are a few words which comes up from these great people. I have got some of them in this webinar only. So it again repeats, where will you be in the next 5 years depends on the books you actually read, the people you associate with, that is your collaboration, and of course, followed up the actions that you take to do that. Okay, so Act Connect Redefining Businesses is organizations which was conceived 2 years back with a noble vision of world abundance through business re-education. This is the vision of the Action Coach. Here at Connect Redefining Businesses, we walk together with the business owners on a systematic one-to-one basis. Mostly, rarely we do group coaching, because in India we find it difficult. When we try to do a business coaching, people actually does not want to open up clean. Whereas there are examples outside India where people prefer group coaching. But somehow we are in this country, so we would be, concentrating on one-to-one coaching as of now. And we help the businessman, the entrepreneur, to take their thoughts and their businesses to the next level upwards and achieve their desired outcomes organically. There is no magic in growth. Growth is an organic extension of the potential of the entrepreneur. Growth is an organic extension of the potential of the entrepreneur. Our key focus is strategic planning. Our hot favorite subject is sales team building, with sales and marketing, because I personally feel that sales is the blood of the organization. Sales is business and business is sales. If you are in business, you are in sales. Take it. Okay. If you are not in sales and if you still think that you want to do business, you can just leave the business. It is not going to happen at all. Sales is business and business is sales. Systems optimization. Yes, of course, you can do anything, but if it is in a systematic way, you reach your outcome organically faster with a greater team. And end of all these exercises, which will give you a profitability for which you are doing this business. Okay. So I go ahead. This was a brief introduction about the organizations which we have set up. And we are trying to take it to the next level at this particular moment. Okay. Now, let's get into the subject. It's nothing but action. Okay, we can say a lot of things, we can think a lot of things, but without action, it doesn't happen. Okay, the last word which takes care of all your vision, mission, outcome, whatever English is there, is the action which you take for your goal. So, let's go ahead. There's a small poll out here. Let's take the poll. What do you expect from this webinar? Easy sales, more sales, tested and measured sales. The second question is, what is important? Sales, profit, or cash? The third question is, how many sources of inquiries do you really follow in your business? Everybody says all of the above. That's great. What is important? Profit is important. That's great. We will discuss about it. The first answer is tested and measured sales. Fantastic. We have got 25, 75. 40, 60, it's slowly changing, and it has, okay, in case of the how many sources of inquiries do you follow? Okay, loyalty bonus, a very interesting subject, definitely. Your customers are actually your sales force. Digital marketing, yes. Okay, cold call. I like this. I really like this. Cold call. I go back to my early days when we used to keep on getting into it. Okay. So what do you expect from this webinar? 60% said tested and measured sales. Great. 30% said more sales. 1% said it is easy sales. My friend, one thing I can promise you, you can never have easy sales. Okay? Unfortunately, you can never have easy sales. You can have more sales, you can have tested and measured sales, but believe me, the path to sales is never on the easy path. Okay? What is important? Sales, profit, and cash. Okay? That's very interesting. Nobody is interested in cash. Everybody is interested in sales and profit. Great. How many sources of inquiries do you follow? One poor guy who says cold call. He is my good friend. Digital marketing, the current trend. Loyalty bonus, the evergreen trend. All of the above. Yes, it can be a mixture. Thank you so much. Which we will go to the next part of this poll. It was a fantastic poll and we have got some good answers on that. What are leads? Leads are actually the plasma of your business. Now, can somebody put it in the chat? What is actually plasma? Can somebody put it on the chat? What is the meaning of plasma? Come on, friends, put something on the chat to see, understand that, you know, you are actually trying to be in this subject and trying put some of your ideas. What is the meaning of plasma? Today we are talking about plasma in a big way. Anybody? The core in the blood. Okay. Okay. It's the main component of the blood. Fine. Okay. The colorless liquid part of the blood. Oh, great. The blood. Okay. Let's come out with the answer. The plasma is actually 55% of your body. We are talking a lot regarding this plasma today in this corona period. So, plasma is one of the very important factors today in our body, for which we are trying to, you know, look for plasma when somebody is very seriously ill. And similarly, leads are like plasma of your business, which actually constitutes 55% of your business. All other things like, you know, red blood corpuscles, white blood corpuscles, or maybe the platelets, everything constitutes the 45%. If I put that same thing in the business, 55% are your leads. Without leads, your business does not go anywhere. And everything together, including yourself as an entrepreneur, are in between that 45%. Okay? So, leads are the plasma of your business. Please give more attention to this. Yes. I am talking about leads and not lead. Okay? I am talking about leads and not lead. Now, what is the difference between a lead and a lead? Lead is only one lead. Leads are multiple leads. Everybody is into sales, right? We all know. The more we put in the funnel, the probability of results increases. A single lead in your organization is actually very lonely. When you carry only one lead with you in a day, you feel frustrated. You become completely engaged with that lead. You start overselling to that lead. But when you have got a funnel of leads, a multiple of leads, you are more confident in converting some of them into your system. So leads are more better than a single lead. But unfortunately today, some of us, or I will say many of us, you know, get satisfied when they actually get one lead. They feel that, you know, they have done a great job. I'm sorry to say, brother, that's not a great job. When you find out ways to make more leads, then only it's a great job, because the probability of success increases. Okay, so let's think about it. We will talk about the 8 steps of the sales process. I will just give a gist about it. I will not discuss about it in frame, but just for people, the entrepreneurs or the people who are into sales, can understand what are the 8 steps of sales process. Is number one, prospecting. Number two is something very different, but unfortunately everybody thinks that sales process is only closing the deal, which is not. Sales process is not closing the deal only. There are other steps which leads to closing the deal. That's very important. Okay, so let us start by one. I have already shown you one, that is the prospecting, hunting the leads from the market. It's one of the most crucial process activity. By the way, it is the most lively activity which can make you rich with leads. Number two, connecting the leads. Connecting yourself with the leads. It's not only that you get a bunch of leads and you just sit on it. No, you have to connect to all those leads. The third important is qualifying those leads which you have connected, whether they are category A leads or category B leads, or it is a very high quality lead. So qualifying the leads are very important. We will not spend some more time on this. I will come to that later. When you are qualifying a lead, you have to actually demonstrate value to that lead. Because if you don't demonstrate value, if you don't show value, that lead will never get into the next level. When a lead comes to you and it is you are connecting with them, you are qualifying it, they are looking for value inside it. What I will get from this person, what I will get from this product, and what I will get from this organization. So demonstrating the value is the most important. Next one, when your lead starts asking, they are not objections, but they are their understanding. So it is basically to find out how to address their objections or give them the clarifications what they want about the product or the services what you are selling. Then comes your closing the deal. If you don't follow this process one by one, then you cannot actually close the deal. These are all certified processes which has to be followed meticulously, organically, so that you can actually qualify to close the deal. The last one is the most interesting one. The second last one, sorry. When you close the deal, you want the check from him, right? Because no sales is complete without money. So getting him on the board, onboarding the client, he becomes a client, then onboarding the prospect onto your board is basically transferring a prospect to a client, followed by follow-up. So it's not necessary that, you know, when you close the deal, your job is over. No. When you close the deal and the prospect has agreed to be on board with you, still there are chances that they may slip out because they have not given you the check. And on top of all that, they have not given you a check which is supposed to be deposited today and the money is in your bank. So the commitment has not happened. You know what system says? System says that, can you see this slide properly? 80% of the sales require 5 follow-ups. But 44% of salespeople give up after one time. Do you agree on this? If you agree, or if you disagree, please put it up in the chat. That 80% of the sales are happening only after 5 follow-ups. If you see, it doesn't happen in one follow-up. But unfortunately, 44% of us, of the salespeople, actually give up after one time. They think, it will not happen. It will not happen. Correct? So, that makes a loss in your effort, what you have been doing. So, when you actually go through the entire process and you get tired in your follow-up region, then it becomes difficult. Okay, so the follow-up is the last one which actually takes care of your entire effort, starting from prospecting to connecting, qualifying, demonstrating the value, addressing the objections, closing the deal, onboarding, and follow-up. So here is a slide which talks about the lead generation maturity model. The undefined lead generation model to the progressive one, to the matured one, and to the world-class one. Now, friends, this subject we will talk at length in anybody who's interested to have, you know, a Zoom meeting with me. The time is on Monday, and there will be a link which will be shared during the last point of the slide. If anybody is interested to know more details about the 8 steps as well as the lead generation maturity model, please join me there on an interactive Zoom meeting only. People who are here only, they will be allowed to join in that meeting. No new person will be taken there. There will be no advertisement. There will be no, you know, featuring out in the Facebook or something to get into the lead generation maturity model, how to understand it. So that depth, that discussions on depth will happen on Monday. The link will be shared in the chat box at the last slide. So wait for that. We'll be happy to be with you there. Okay? Okay, the next one. So we will talk about this at length because this was just the subject on that. Okay. Now, let's see what is there. It's a complete blank screen. What it shows, what it comes with, is very important to understand what it comes with actually. It comes with a test. I'm sorry, no, it is not your test at all. It's test and measure of what you have been doing, starting from doing the cold calls, you know, measuring and all the 8 steps of sales. Remember one thing. If you are not able to test and measure what you have been doing, you are not going to the next step. Because whatever the process you adopt while doing something, it is not necessary that all those processes are actually correct at that particular moment. So you have to keep on testing and measuring the processes, what you do, and tweak it out, change it, or keep it the same depending upon the requirement. Okay, so the most important part of any sales process or any process in organizations per se is that you have to keep on testing and measuring. If you do not test and measure, then how will you evaluate whether you're doing the right thing or not? That's very important. So let's play a game. Okay, it's a very interesting game. Let's play this game. So let's talk about number of leads, conversion rate, give you the number of customers with you. Each customer is going to do n number of transactions with you. And each transaction will have an average INR value for that, which gives you the revenue. All the revenue what you generate from your sales is not your profit. A certain percentage, because those are the sales value, which is different from your purchase value. So the difference between your sales value minus the expenses of your organization, fixed expenses and variable expenses, gives the profit margin, and that gives your net profit. So let's put some figures. Say for example, 4,000 leads you have generated in last month. And let's take a ballpark figure of 25% conversion. We are able to convert 25% of 4,000 leads. So how much it comes? Anybody in the chat box, how much it comes? 1,000. Okay, that's great. That's great. So if it is 1,000, let's put 1,000. Now let's take an example. If each and every customer does 2 transactions in a month, okay, 2 transactions, and so how many transactions does he do? So each customer is doing 2 transactions. So how many transactions is happening in that month? 2,000 transactions is happening in the month. Correct. Correct, Tiraj. So there are 2 transactions which is happening in that month. And now if I take each transactional value is 1,000 rupees only. So what's the revenue? Come on, somebody type on the chat box, what's the revenue? 1,000 customers doing 2 transactions each of 1,000 rupees value. It's only a ballpark figure. Really? Somebody's writing 4 million, right? No, I'm sorry. It's 20 lakhs. There are 6 zeros, the old way of mathematics. There are 6 zeros and 2 into 1 into 1 makes it 2. So that is 20 lakhs. And for example, if you're lucky enough, if you're making 25% margin on that, how much profit do we make? How much profit do we make if 25% of 20 lakhs, how much it is? So simple. Yes, Project, it is 5 lakh. Simple. It's very interesting. You can actually take this to your organization and find out how to measure your leads converting into sales. Now, let's see. If we do a little bit of change into this, what is the change? We just take 10%. We just want to improve because every month is a month of improvement, correct? So here we will not take 25% improvement or 30% improvement. No, we will take a very small improvement, 10%. Because small improvements actually give bigger impacts. So let's take 10%. If I take 10%, then 4,000 becomes 4,400. Am I correct? Say yes or no. Am I correct? You can type Y, or you can, if I'm not correct, you can type N. No issues. Yes. And similarly, 10% of conversion rate, we have also tried to improve it to 10% more, which makes it 27.5. So what we have done? We are trying to improve 10% in each and every stage of our sales activity, starting from leads to sales. That makes this 1250. Okay. Now, similarly, on a mathematical background, we make the transaction as 2.2, the same 10%. As well as your average sale value of 1,000 rupees, if I increase it by 10%, how much it becomes? Can anybody type how much it becomes? 10% of 1,000. Correct. Only I have got only one answer here this time. Two answers this time. Okay, let's go. It is perfect. It is 1100. Now, let's see the revenue. Okay. Just one answer from anybody. Take a 10 seconds time to understand what will be the revenue. Let us take 10 seconds and any one of you can write down, can chat it down there, what will be the revenue. This is very interesting. If you are not good at mathematics, you are not good at sales. Because every time you have to carry on talking about the percentage, the time and everything, everything is sales. Mathematics is sales and sales is mathematics. 28 lakh something. There is nothing called 28 lakh something. That should be a perfect figure. Project has given the perfect figure of 29,28,200. Yes. So, my friends, can you understand what is happening? Just by implementing 10% difference in your effort in each and every step which you have taken, it has given you an extra revenue of 9,28,200. Isn't it amazing? Just think, you could have done a 20%. It would have gone somewhere else. I have only taken 10% because small steps, big impacts. Now, similarly, when we do something on the profit of margin, the same 10% value, it becomes 27.5. And here I give you the answer of the profit. From 5 lakhs, it goes up to 8 lakhs. 5,255. So your net profit has increased by 3 lakhs of rupees only for a 10% difference of thought which you have done for your sales process from your leads to sale. Are you liking it? Is it interesting? You can type Y, or if you're not interested, you can type no. Nothing to worry about it, because we can always share on doing this. Okay, so it's just a small change. Again, I repeat the same word. A small change brings a bigger impact. Try that. That's really, really important. Now, what you got? What actually you got out of this is again mathematics. Okay, if I go back, and if I come forward, what is the increase of the revenue? 9,28,200 over 20 lakhs gives you 46% increase in your revenue. So a change in 10% brings 46% increase in revenue, and it not stops there. There is more. I have not spoken about the main part. What is that main part? That main part is the net profit. So, if I go back again, you will see the profit is around 3 lakhs approximately over 5 lakhs. So, what do you think? What is the percentage of profit which has increased? Can anybody type it down there? What is the percentage of growth in net profit which has happened just by increasing 10% on each and every category of sales? Come on, friends. Please keep the chat box buzzing so that you know it makes more interesting, because this is simple mathematics. Sales cannot happen without mathematics. Business cannot happen with sales. So business cannot happen with mathematics. We need to know that. Is it very tough to calculate? What is the percentage of growth in profit when you are achieving 8 lakhs of profit in place of 5 lakhs of profit? Probably, don't use the word probably. It doesn't happen in sales at all. There is nothing called probably. There is always an exact figure. What is the figure? It is 70%. You have got into the figure, but the answer is not right. If you are an entrepreneur, you have to be very careful understanding your mathematics. It's very important. There is no sales without mathematics. There is no business without sales. And hence, there is no business without mathematics. Okay? So it is very simple. It is 8,05,255 minus 5 lakh gives you 3,05,255 divided by 5 lakh, which gives you a massive profit of 61%. So a 10% change in your thought process, in your each and every steps, which is very easy to derive, because you are not going for a very high figure, you are going for minimum figure. It gives you 46% increase in your revenue and 61% increase in your profit. If I'm wrong, please write WR. If my calculations are wrong, please write WR. I will wait for 10 seconds out here to understand that I am wrong. Okay. That the system is wrong, this is not happening, this will not happen. If somebody thinks that this will not happen, or any other questions, you can keep on putting questions, we will definitely take up this question. That by increasing only 10% effort in each and every level of your process, you achieved 46% more in case of the revenue and 61% more in case of your profit. A simple mathematics. I'm not talking about taking a goal of which I saw a lot of companies, you know, they do it. Say that next month we need to do 25% more leads. We need to have 25% more customers. No. Take small steps, organic steps, baby steps. It will give you an awesome result, and that is what it is showing out here. Are you all okay with this? If you agree, I can go ahead. There is one more interesting subject out here. So, we talked about leads to sales. Now let's talk about something which is already there in your organization. That is your database. If your business is for 1 year old, or it may be 80 years old, end of the day, you should have a good systematic database. If that database is cultured, then your profitability and your revenue also builds up another. We will show you that how it happens. Because by leveraging the old database, you are not adding any new manpower to it. What you are doing, you are only adding a referral scheme to it. Your same manpower in the organization can sit and talk to the old database. And remind them of their delight when they have purchased a product from you or they have taken services from you. They are your referral customers. So, a similar example, number of old customers. How much? Say, for example, 2000, if it is, you know, a 3 years or a 4 years business, whatever the value of the customer, it can be, I have taken a ballpark figure of 2000. And out of 2000, they can be a repeat customer or they can give you a referral customer. If you can talk to those 2000 customers through a proper logical thought process, we see a good conversion of 500 people from them. And each 500 guys, if they do the same process what we are doing, two transactions of a value of 1,000 rupees, also generates a revenue which is completely new in the system, which was never thought of also, which comes to around 10 lakhs. So the previous slide was of the new leads getting generated and then we are fighting on them incremented. This particular slide, we are talking about the leads which has already been transferred into customers around a year back or a 2 years back time. Depending upon the number of customers, it can be 2,000, it can be 1,000, it can be 10,000, whatever it is, depending upon the service. Okay. The referral rate, 25%, has been tested by few companies which I know and we have tested there with the proper effort. So coming to this equation of 2,000 on 25%, we get 500 customers where if our average INR sale is 1,000 rupees for two transactions, we give 10 lakhs in addition to your 20 lakhs or 29 lakhs. It's an ever-going process. And again, I take a 25%. I have not changed the system so fast because it becomes very complicated. If some of you will not be able to calculate it immediately. So I have kept those figures, which is easy to calculate. And this 10 lakhs or 25% will give 2,55,000 additionally, correct village. So now what happens? This 10 lakhs and 2,50,000 gets added. Okay. The revenue 10 lakhs and it gets added on 29 lakhs, 28,200 plus 10 lakhs gives you 39 lakhs, 20,000. 200, correct? And the new profit, which was not taken there, is becomes 10,55,225. Anybody wants to chat on something, tell something, please let us know. Because this is a simple mathematics. We are not giving any type of, you know, dictations or not any type of words which are putting up there. It's a simple mathematics because I strongly believe sales is mathematics and business is sales. So business won't happen without mathematics. So it is better to understand what is the mathematics. I go back to 10 lakhs. And then again, I go back to 29 lakhs, which have got into the 10% increment. So 10 lakhs and 29 lakhs makes it 39 lakhs, 28,200 as the incremental revenue after doing this process. The second one was your net profit. The net profit has gone up to how much? The net profit has actually gone up to 10,55,225. So 2,55,50,000 here and 8 lakh there. That gives you 10 lakhs now. This is more interesting. Net growth in profit. So if your organization, if your team, and if yourself are working hard on what you try to derive, if that goal is set, everything is set. So what we have been doing, we have started from 4,000 number of leads. We have given them a 10% incremental touch on those 4,000 leads in the second month. Started working on the existing customers, trying to derive lead from them. We are trying to actually convert them into our referral partners. And then when we see that collective growth of your organization, it comes to around the growth in profit only 111%. And your revenue increases by 96%. This is how it happens. So when you keep on running your figures in your system, you will understand how that lead is getting converted into sales and how sales is converted into profits. So going back to the first poll, there was nobody who actually thought that it is not only sales, it is not only profit, it is the cash which is important. Everybody thought that what is important is sales and what is important is the profit. Yes, of course. But when you see the sales and the profit, you also need that cash. Because without that cash, your next step doesn't happen. Your organization doesn't go. You will not be able to think your next step. So there is a saying about it. Sales is vanity. I repeat the word, sales is vanity. I have done 40 crore sales in last year. It's vanity. Okay? I have done 40 crore sales in last year. I have done 20% growth from the last year. Yes, great, gentlemen. You have done 20% growth. You have done 40%, 40 crore turnover this year. I have made profit also. See my books. The chartered accountant says, your books shows that you are already into 4 crore plus cash in your statement. But my dear gentlemen, where is the cash? The cash is in the market. I have sold materials. The payment has not come. I have done my sale. I made profits, which is in the books. But the profit is not getting reflected in the pocket of the organization. So sales is vanity. Profit is sanity. But cash is reality. Remember one thing. Cash is reality. If you are dealing with somebody, if you are quoting somebody, please be specific about your payment terms. Otherwise, whatever you see here in the profit and the revenue doesn't carry at all any meaning whatsoever in your effort. So all sales quotations, everything boils down to your payment collection. Nothing to feel shy about it when we tell that, okay, my payment collection is this. People think that, oh my God, if I talk about payments right now, the sale will not come, man. He will not give me the sale. Do you think, guys? Does this fear happen to you that, you know, if we talk about the money first, the sales will not come? I used to fear a lot in my early days. If I tell them, boss, you have to give me the check along with the PO, I used to be very afraid in my initial days until the time when my boss came up and said, if you don't collect a check and bring a sale, I don't need you, because it doesn't make any difference. The only difference which makes in the business is that you get the check along with your PO. And asking for the check along with the PO is only when you have come out of your fear of losing the sale. The fear of losing the sale will come out of you when we have got not only one lead, but you have got numbers of leads with you. Remember, going back to the 8th slide where we say it is not lead, we are into leads. So it's a complete process. There is no magic from slide number 1 to slide number 19. There is no magic. It's a complete process. So if you are able to come out of the fear, it is not because you are a brave guy. It is because your process was actually very correct. That you have not depended on one lead. You have got multiples of lead. You can actually afford to lose one lead because of a bad payment condition. Fear. Please write it down, a note somewhere. What is a fear? A fear is a false expectation appearing right. False expectations appearing real. Agar main check mangunga, to mera order nahi aayega. That is the reality which I thought, but that may not be the reality. If it is a reality that the moment you ask the check, your order will go out of the hand, it better be, because that customer will never be your fruitful client. It will give you pain in your later days when you are trying to supply materials to him or you're trying to give services. And I can promise you, if you don't put a proper strainer inside your system, you will get more of these type of people, which will be always be very sweet at the beginning, but very sour at the end. So understand those people. There are category of customers. You have to categorize them. There are 4 categories of customers. We will talk about that in some of the other sessions on a one-to-one basis. I go forward. Sorry, I'm exceeding my time, but I would like to continue a little bit more. Give me some 2-3 minutes more. It will be more interesting. What would you like to do extra with this 10,55,225 or with an 111% more profit? I really want to know. I really want to know what would you like to do with this extra 10,55,000. Come on, keep on chatting on the chat box. Please write what you want to do. Somebody's written in the panelist only. Please write down in the panelist attendees. Yes, he wants to buy a BMW. Okay. Somebody is trying, okay. A bungalow and Karjat, okay. Expanding. Of course, expanding the business, putting the money back into the business. Okay. If you are an entrepreneur, you will not only buy a BMW or, you know, a bungalow, a plush bungalow in Sanchez, you will also put some money back into the business for the expansion, give more employment. Correct. So by putting back into the business, you create more subjects, you create more employment, you are giving back to the society. Think about it. Correct? Any more? Please don't answer the panelists. I feel proud when you're looking for a BMW, definitely. But please don't write in the panelists. Other people cannot see that. Okay? So, what is the next? A very important thing. What is the next? The next is who? The next is who will do it. Very different, very important. Who will do it? That is action plan. We have got all the systems to do it. Who will do it? Who will do what? And by when? If you had a 4,000 number of leads with you, then who will talk to those leads and get 10%, process those leads or get into a new lead to do that? Who does what and by when? My dear entrepreneurs, this is one of the biggest systems which you have to implement in your organization, even as, because when you are an entrepreneur, you're also a salesperson. So whatever your sales team is doing, you also need to do the same thing in a bigger magnitude. So every step in the organization has to actually find out who does what and by when. That gives you a proper understanding of the test and measure process. I would like to quote this, you know, of Mr. Warren Buffett. Warren Buffett is a world famous investor. He also traveled through the entrepreneur ladder from the beginning of the days. And he is probably the world's second wealthiest man, if I'm not mistaken. I am really not sure, but he is the second wealthiest man, around 48 million net worth. He says, it is not necessary to do extraordinary things to get extraordinary result. It is not necessary to do extraordinary thing to get extraordinary results. A small bubble can give you a bigger impact. A small change can also bring you a massive change. Small rivers which flows towards the central extension becomes a big ocean. So it is not necessary to do extraordinary things to get extraordinary results. That is what Warren Buffett says, and I think I believe it strongly. Do small things and get things together at least to get a bigger impact. Kaizen is a Japanese word for change, good. Okay. One thing is constant in life. That is change. Constant is equal to change. If you don't change, you will become stagnant. If you change, you will keep on moving. Such constant and never-ending improvement is actually when you grow to a plateau, stay there for some time, again grow, and then again go to a plateau. What it helps, it actually helps you to stabilize at that growth level. There is no fun, there is no magic when you grow like this and you fall like this. There is a fun when you grow like this, stay at a particular place, and then again grow and then again stay in that particular place and take your full organization along with you. Because remember one thing, you are an entrepreneur, you have given people their life to work with you. So the steps of the organization is very important for the longevity of the organization. Okay, so this is a disclaimer which I thought that, you know, people keep on running. I have to go up. Everybody has to go up. But there has to be, you know, a process to go up. And there has to be a stability in growing up. So now is the time to get into action. Please use this, you know, equation in your own organizations, in your own areas, and try to get impact out of it. The impact is our journey is a commitment of conviction, growth, and delivery. We are basically here to transform a business into a commercially profitable enterprise which works without you. And this is the tagline of my principal company, Action Coach by Brad Sugars. And once you are free from your current business, you are actually free to do more. Because if you get into the integration of the simple organizations and two small bits in organization, then you will not get a time to grow more, to do more. Okay? More to discuss and implement. If you want to, you can associate with us and we will help you to push your business with, of course, with speed and resilience. With this, I end up this session. Thank you so much for being with us. We have promised you a 1 hour session. I have just crossed it by 5 minutes. Please get in touch. The mobile numbers are given below. My landline number is not working right now because they're in the office and we are not able to access our office. The email ID is there. The website is there. We are really honored to have you here in this forum and give us time and have lend your ears to listen to us. Probably we have kept our words to deliver whatever we wanted to deliver. Our next engagement is niche. Why people will buy from you. I always think I am the best. Mom always thinks her son or her daughter is the best. But when the best cannot be the best letter, cannot get the best result later, brings a lot of questions. So we need to find out the niche, why people will buy from you. And we are coming on 22nd of May, this month only at 11 a.m. The link has been shared in the chat box. So you can always, it is there in the chat box. So please join us and also ask your friends to join us in this. We will be trying to deliver whatever we'll say and we will try to find out more discussions today. Thank you so much. Okay. So any questions? I'm ready to answer any questions which are there with you. If you can raise your hands, we will find out. So there are this Docs Google form for the Monday meeting. You can always get in touch with us for the Monday thing. Okay, so with this, I take a leave from you. We end this session. Thank you so much once again to be with us. We will be again back to